the single greatest accomplishment of my human life was arresting my addiction to opiates and alcohol.
Jamie Lee Curtis is many things: an actress, an author, an addiction survivor, and an actual baroness. Seriously. But before all that, she was the girl who survived. Back in 1978, the movie Halloween gave birth to the slasher movie genre, and it also turned Jamie Lee Curtis into a star. And now, all these years later, she is back, not just to survive, but to have her final revenge.
So I can kill him.
Do it again. Yeah, you have a very bad clap. Do you want a really good clap?
Yeah, do you want to give me a good clap? Oh, there it is. That's a good skill. Everybody needs a friend that's a good clap starter.
I'm a clap starter.
I should probably say hi to you.
Hello.
I'm Mark.
Nice I'm to Jamie. Meet you, Jamie. Hi, Mark.
So one of the striking things about this film is that a couple of minutes in, you realize it's actually a film about trauma.
All this hiding, all this preparation, it was for nothing. I mean, it took priority over your family. It cost you your family.
This trauma that has sustained for a really long time. And I was curious, what about that idea? What was it about that concept that appealed to you?
You know, we make horror movies. Well, I don't.
I'm in them, but I don't like them.
But we make these movies, but we never talk about what happens to anybody. Mm. You know, we inflict this sort of intense experience on unsuspecting, often young people. But then we never revisit it and never know really what happened. And throughout the world, traumas happen. And we very rarely go back and ask, how are you doing? And I loved that this was a movie that went back 40 years later to explore and to expose the realities of trauma on a human being who is not given any mental health services, help, support, etc.
That's the idea.
So today we will be reading one of our favorite books.
Welcome to Storytime with Erin.
We are going to read
Tell Me Again.
Tell Me Again About the Night I Was Born by Jamie Lee Curtis, illustrated by Laura Cornell.
You wrote a beautiful book called Tell Me About the Night I Was Born.
Yes.
And it's an exploration of adopting children.
Yes.
You've adopted children yourself, and I've heard you describe it as a sacred gift.
It is.
What did you mean by that? For somebody that's never experienced it, what does that term mean?
So, families are built through all sorts of ways, but the act of placing, of carrying and birthing a child and placing that child in the receiving hands of a mother who is in that moment declaring that she will throw down her own life and sacrifice every single thing that she has for the care and raising and feeding of that child. That exchange is a sacred exchange, but the gift may not be a sacred gift for the child because that is theirs to work out whether or not they are happy about it or sad about it or angry about it. A lot of people misunderstand adoption, and they use pejorative words and phrases to go along with it. So they'll say things like, did you buy your baby? They'll say in front of your child, that's not your real mom, right? And so I wrote a book out of my experience of trying to realign people's idea of what it means to have an adoptive family. I actually wrote it primarily for that nasty mom in my daughter's kindergarten class.
Was this a real person or imaginary person?
You know, let me just say there's a little bit of a composite, if I will. But, you know, she said something like, well, no, she's not her real mom, or something horrible. And I remember like going like, okay.
Here's a book for Christmas.
Yeah, I'm going to go home and write a book, and then I'm going to shove it up your...
It was cathartic then for you?
Well, everything I have ever done is cathartic.
Really?
I've written 14 books for children. Everyone has come out of me in a weird birthing process of their own. Mm. I refer to it as the closest to rap that I will ever do. I interviewed once LL Cool J was in the movie Halloween H2O, and I said something about... So this whole freestyling thing, is that like real? Like, are you telling me you could freestyle about anything right here, right now? And he said, yeah. And I said, okay, freestyle about the mashed potatoes. And he did. And that flow is no different than the books that I've written for children. They come out of me in a flow, and they come out all intact. Almost entirely the book that is published is what I pops into my head.
I'm curious of all then, of all the different projects you've done, so let's take books, TV shows, movies, there's been milestones.
You have, like, you're omitting commercials.
Okay, well, let's include commercials as
okay,
well.
Okay, please, thank
you. The reason I'm setting it up that way is because I want to know, of the different projects you've done, which one changed you the most?
It wasn't work.
It wasn't work?
No.
So what
no.
was it?
I got sober.
How hard was that?
That was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. And it is a most human thing to say, I am in trouble, I need help. We overanalyze it, we oververbalize it, and I think it scares people off because it seems daunting. And I can tell you from my own experience that the single greatest accomplishment of my human life was arresting my addiction to opiates and alcohol. And I talk to people all day long about addiction because it is not us. If it's a secret, it will kill you. Mm-hmm. If it's not a secret, you may be able to save your own life.
So what would you tell yourself about that process that you wish you had known before you had embarked on the process of sobriety?
You know what? The truth of the matter is, nobody is ready until they're ready. Nobody can hear things until they're ready to hear them. And so there would be nothing I could have said to me that would have helped me in that moment. I had to come to that understanding myself and seek help the way I did. We all would like to go back to our younger selves. How old are you?
33.
All right, you're 33. I'm going to be 60 in November on Thanksgiving. We all would like to go back to our 15-year-old self, and we'd all say, lighten up, it's going to be okay, you're beautiful, you're going to have a happy life. We all would like to go back to our 15-year-old selves and give ourselves a hug and a real cuddle and say it's going to be okay. Everybody walked through glass, broken glass and fire in their adolescence. Everybody, nobody got through that unscathed. It is the it's the process of human evolution. It's a difficult time. And so the message I would give you, me, and anybody who's watching this anywhere in the world is you're going to be okay.
Jamie Curtis.
Thank you. Lovely to talk to you. I could talk to you all day long.